Let's go through problems in exercise 1.1, which is related to matrix addition, matrix transpose, matrix subtraction, and scalar multiplication. The first problem is, if A is equal to this, find 2A and 3A. 2A is nothing but 2 times of A. So, this is matrix A. 2 times of this means, you have to take each element of this particular matrix, multiply with 2, like this. 2 into 1, 2 into minus 2, 2 into 3, 2 into 4. So, you get the values here. So, you get this. This is nothing but matrix 2A. Similarly, we'll do for 3a. For 3a, 3 into every element in this matrix. So, it's going to be 3 into 1, 3 into minus 2, 3 into 3, 3 into 4. So, you'll get 3 minus 6, 9 and 12. So, this is 3a. Let's take another problem. If A is this particular matrix, find 5 times of A transpose. 5 times of A transpose. Now, first we will have to find A transpose, right? First, we'll have to find what A transpose is. A transpose is interchange the rows and columns. We'll have 1, minus 3, 5. You'll take this row. You'll make this as column. Now, take the second row, make it as a column. So, it'll be 6, 2, 4. Right? Now, you multiply this particular matrix with 5. So, you get 5 A transpose, which is 5 times of 1, minus 3, 5, 6, 2, 4. Let's multiply each of this. So, you get 5 into 1, 5 into 6, 5 into minus 3, 5 into 2, 5 into 5, and 5 into 4, which is nothing but 5, 30, minus 15, 10, 25, and 20. So, this is the final matrix for 5A transpose. Now, let's go to the third problem. If matrix A is given and matrix B is given, find matrix A plus B and matrix A minus B. This is direct matrix addition. So, matrix A plus B would be, just add these two matrices. So, it will be 1, 2, 4, minus 1, 3, minus 2, plus this matrix. 3, minus 4, minus 1, 1, 5, minus 2. Now, you will have to add 1 plus 3, that is 4. 2 minus 4 is minus 2. 4, 4 minus 1 is 3. Minus 1 plus 1 is 0. 3 plus 5 is 8. Minus 2 plus of minus 2 is going to be minus 4. So, this is A plus B. Similarly, let's find A minus B. So, A minus B is nothing but matrix subtraction. Let's take one by one. We'll get 1, this element, 1 minus of 3. The next one is 2 minus of minus 4, these two. Third one is 4 minus of this one, minus 1. Let's go to second row. Here you have minus 1, minus 1, minus 1, this one. Then we'll take 3 minus this element, 5. Then minus 2 minus minus 2, this element. So, if you evaluate this, you're going to get 1 minus 3 is minus 2, 2 plus 4 is 6, 4 plus 1 is 5, minus 2, minus 2, minus 2, plus 2 is 0. So, this is matrix A minus B. Now, let's take one problem where they've given two matrices and they've given the sum of these two matrices. That is, when you add these two matrices, you get this matrix. You have to find X. Right? So, what we'll have to do? We'll have to find elements where there is X. So, you have X here and you have X here. And when you add these two, you'll get this element, the corresponding element. So, this is the first element in first row and first column. Similarly, we'll have to take first element in the first row and first column of this particular matrix. So, you'll have to add X square plus 2X is equal to minus 1. Now, we'll take minus 1 this side. So, you'll have X square plus 2x plus 1 is equal to 0. Now, we'll have to find the value of x. So, you'll have to use the quadratic equation formula to find the roots, right? To find roots of quadratic equation, there is a formula called as x is equal to minus b plus or minus root of b square minus 4ac by 2a. This formula gives us the values of x. This is considering that the equation is ax square plus bx plus c is equal to 0. So, if we have an equation like this, where ax square plus bx plus c is equal to 0, then the formula to find the value of x is this one, minus b plus or minus root of b square minus 4ac by 2a. So, you'll have to take one root with plus and the other root with minus. So, let's do this. This is a, this is a, this is b, this is c, right? Now, instead of a, we don't have any number here, which means there is 1. So, a is 1. And what is b here? This is b. This coefficient of x is b. B is 2, plus 2. And c, What is c? C is equal to plus 1. Right? A is the coefficient of x square. So now we'll find the value of x. Value of x is minus b. What is minus b? Minus 2 plus or minus root of, what is b square? Plus 2, the whole square. This is b square minus 4 into a is 1. C is 1. So 1 divided by 2a. 2 into a, that is 1. So let's evaluate this. So we'll get x is equal to minus 2 plus or minus 2 square is 4 minus 4 by 2 into 1 is 2. Now this is nothing but minus 2 plus or minus 4 minus 4 is 0. Root of 0 is 0. So you will get this. So now x will be, one root of x will be minus 2 plus 0 by 2. Another root of x will be minus 2 minus of 0 by 2. So you'll have to take one expression with plus and the other expression with minus. Two separate expressions. So minus 2 plus 0, minus 2 minus 0 and divide by 2. So we'll get x is equal to, since 0 does not carry any value here, so it will be minus 2 by 2. Here also it's going to be minus 2 by 2, which is nothing but minus 1. So value of x is nothing but minus 1. Let's find this problem where matrix A is given. We'll have to find A plus A transpose. Very simple, right? First, A. What is matrix A? We'll write it down. Matrix A is 2x minus x minus 7 plus, what is A transpose? A transpose is, you have to interchange rows and columns. So 2 minus x is the row. We'll put it as column. Next row is x minus 7. We'll put that also as column. X minus 7. So this is transpose. Now if you add 2 plus 2, that is 2 plus 2 minus x plus x, this one, then this one and this one, x minus x, then this one and this one, minus 7 minus 7. So we'll get 4, this is 0, this will get cancelled. This also will get cancelled, 0 minus 14. So A plus A transpose is this particular matrix. Let's find this problem where A matrix is given. We'll have to find matrix X and this is the given expression. So A minus 2X is equal to this particular matrix. Now we'll have to find matrix X. So to find matrix X, we'll have to move everything else to the other side. So let's do this step by step. So we'll first move A this side, right? So it's going to be minus 2X is equal to this matrix. We'll just copy. Plus A will become minus A. We just want X, right? So we'll have to shift this here. This is 2 into X. So when you shift it, it's going to become 1 by 2. It's going to be division. And we'll move minus also here. So this will become, and remember one thing, you have to put a bracket here because this movement of 2 is not only for this particular matrix, it's also applying for this, right? So put a bracket and then minus half of this entire thing. So we'll get x is equal to minus half. Let's substitute this matrix. Then instead of A, what is A? A is 3 minus 1, 3 minus 1, 4 and 5. Now x is equal to minus half into, let's subtract, 1 minus 3 is minus 2. 4 minus of minus 1, 4 minus of minus 1 is 4 plus 1, which is 5. 2 minus 4 is minus 2. Minus 3 minus 5, minus 3 minus 5 is minus 8. Now we will multiply each of these elements with half. Let's write it down. Minus 2 into minus half. We'll have to multiply. 5 into minus half. Minus 2 into minus half. Minus 8 into minus half. Now on evaluation we'll get, this will get cancelled. This will become 4. This will get cancelled. So we'll have minus and minus. This will become plus 1. This will become minus 5 by 2. This will become plus 1. This will become plus 4. So this is matrix X. Now let's take one more problem. We'll have to verify this particular statement that A minus B, the whole transpose, is A transpose minus B transpose. So what we will do? We'll first take LHS. LHS is equal to A minus B, the whole transpose. Let's first get the answer for this. Then take this and get the answer for this. Then we can check if both LHS and RHS have the same matrices. So A minus B, the whole transpose. So A, this is A. A is 1, minus 1, 2, 4, minus B, 3, minus 3, 1, 4. This is B. Now, the entire thing, whatever matrix you get after subtraction, you will have to take transpose of this. So it's going to be, let's first subtract. 1 minus 3 is minus 2. Minus 1 minus 1 is minus 2. 2 minus of minus 3 is going to become 2 plus 3, which is 5. 4 minus of 4 is going to become 0. Now we'll take transpose of this. We will get interchange. Take this particular row, make it as column. So minus 2, minus 2. Next row is 5, 0. Make that as a column. So this is LHS. Let's call this as equation 1. Now we'll take RHS, right? RHS is A transpose minus B transpose. A transpose minus B transpose. So let's evaluate this. A transpose. We know matrix A. What is the transpose of this? Let's just copy this. So we need A transpose. This is matrix A. What will be the A transpose? You'll have to interchange the row and column. It's going to be A transpose is, take this row, 1 minus 1, make it as column. Take second row, 2, 4, make it as column. So we have A transpose. Now, minus B transpose. What is matrix B? This one. Transpose of this is, you have to interchange. So 3, 1. Let's take this first row. 3, 1, make it as column. Second row is minus 3, 4. Let's make it as column. So this is B transpose. Now we'll have to subtract both. 1 minus 3 is minus 2. 2 minus of minus 3 is 5. Minus 1 minus 1 is minus 2. 4 minus 4 is 0. This is RHS. Now let's call this as equation 2. Now let's observe 1 and 2. LHS is this particular matrix. RHS is this particular matrix. Both are same. Therefore, from 1 and 2, we conclude that A minus B, the old transpose, is equal to A transpose minus B transpose. So I've solved a few problems from exercise 1.1. Just to give the basic understanding on matrix addition, matrix subtraction, matrix transpose, and scalar multiplication. Hope this video was useful. Thanks for watching.